وقال سمع الله لمن حمده للإمام والمنفرد.
And also a person saying سبحان رب سمع الله لمن حمده for the person who is an imam and also for the person who is praying alone and not in congregation. They have to say سمع الله لمن حمده.
وقال ربنا ولك الحمد للإمام والمنفرد وللمأموم يعني للجميع.
And as for saying ربنا ولك الحمد, then the imam and the person who is praying in congregation behind the imam and also the person who is praying alone and not in congregation, all of these people have to say ربنا ولك الحمد.
واستحب له أن يزيد بما ورد إلى ربي الحمد حمدا كثيرا طيبا مباركا فيه وغير هذا من أدعية النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم الوارد عنه.
And then it is a recommendation for a person to add to this whatever has been narrated from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم.
قول سبحان ربي الأعلى مرة واحدة في سجوده.
And also from the wajibat, from the obligations of the prayer, is for a person to say at least once سبحان ربي الأعلى in his sujood, in his prostration.
قول رب اغفر لي مرة واحدة بين السجدتين واستحب له أن يزيد. نعم.
And also from the wajibat is a for a person to say رب اغفر لي at least once when in his sitting between the two prostrations, and it is recommended for a person to say it more than once.
والتشهد الأول أي في الصلاة الثلاثية والرباعية أي قراءة التشهد الأول في الصلاة التي فيها أكثر من تشهد. نعم.
And also from the obligations of the prayer is for a person to say the first tashahud, for a person to recite the first tashahud, where there are two tashahud in the prayer. So when there's a prayer of 3 units or 4 units, and there's 2 times a person says tashahud, then the obligation is to say the first tashahud.
والجلوس له أي الجلوس لهذا التشهد التشهد الأول من واجبات الصلاة.
And also for a person to sit for the first tashahud, it's an obligation.
الآن نذكر مبطلات الصلاة.
And now we are going to mention those actions which invalidate a person's prayer.
قبلها نريد أن نبين أنواع الحركات في الصلاة.
So before this, we want to explain the different types of movements in the prayer.
الحركات في الصلاة 5 أنواع.
The different types of movements in the prayer are 5. There's 5 different types of movements in the prayer.
حركة محرمة.
The type of movement which is not allowed.
وحركة مكروهة.
The movement which is disliked.
وحركة مباحة.
The movement which is permitted.
وحركة مستحبة.
The movement which is recommended.
وحركة واجب.
And the movement which is an obligation.
الحركة المحرمة.
So the movement in the prayer which is not permitted, it is
الأكل.
Eating.
والشرب.
Drinking.
والضحك.
Laughing.
والالتفات الكثير عن القبلة.
And also a person moving away or diverting away from the قبلة.
والحركة الكثيرة المتتابعة لغير حاجة حتى تنظر إليه تظن غير مصلي. حركة كثيرة ومتتابعة ولغير حاجة وتنظر إليه تظن غير مصلي. نعم.
And also a person moving consistently, a person moving such without any need, such that if a person was to look at him, he would think that he's not praying.
يعني ما هو يصلي الآن يدق الجوال يخرج الجهاز وينظر في الرسائل ويقول سبحان الله لماذا يتصل علينا في هذا الوقت هذا أو يقول له أنا أصلي مثلا. حركة كثيرة متوالية عرفا يعني في العرف تنظر إليه تظن غير مصلي ولغير حاجة. نعم.
An example of this is a person who whilst he is praying his phone is ringing. So he takes his phone out, he looks at it, he switches it off, he reads through the messages, or he answers the phone call and he says, I'm in the prayer, don't ring me. So this type of movement, it is muharramah, it's not allowed. I, moving the prayer, constantly moving, in which normally a person will look at this person and think that this person isn't praying.
هذا الحركة المحرمة. نعم.
So this is the impermissible type of movement in the prayer.
الثاني الحركة المكروهة.
And then the second type of movement are those movements which are disliked.
هي الحركة القليلة بالكثيرة لكن لغير حاجة. حركة ولكنها قليلة. تنظر إليه تعرف المصلي لكن يتحرك لغير حاجة. نعم.
So this is a person moving a little in the prayer, but he does so without any necessity, such that if a person was to look at him, he would know that he is praying. But he's doing it without any necessity and it's only a little amount of movement.
التفات يصير في الصلاة.
So, and also, a person moving slightly in the prayer.
نعم. الحركة المباحة.
And then those movements which are permitted.
هي الحركة التي تكون لحاجة. الحركة تكون لحاجة. محتاج لهذه الحركة. مثال دق الجوال فبأدنى حركة أدخل يده في جيبه وجعل الجوال على الصامت. نعم.
The permitted or the permissible type of movements in the prayer is any movement that a person has to do as a necessity. As an example, a person is praying and his mobile starts ringing. So with the least amount of movements, he puts his hand in his pocket and he switches off his mobile and then he returns his hand back. This is now something which is permitted due to a necessity.
عندما سجد في صلاته سقطت 50 باوند من جيبه وخاف عليها من السرقة فبأدنى حركة أخذ وضعها في جيبه حركة مباحة جائزة.
When a person is in sujood, when he prostrates, let's say 50 pounds falls out of his pocket and he's scared that somebody might come and steal or take this 50 pounds while he's in the prayer. So with the least amount of movement, he takes his money and he puts it back in his pocket. This is something which is permitted due to a necessity.
حركة مستحبة.
And then we have those movements in the prayer which are recommended, which are mustahab.
هي الحركة التي نتوقف عليها كمال الصلاة. نعم.
And they are those movements in which a person perfects his prayer.
يعني إن لم يتحرك كانت الصلاة صحيحة لكن ناقصة في الأجر.
Meaning that if a person doesn't fulfill this recommended type of movement, although his prayer is correct and valid, but it's not the most perfect. The reward is deficient.
سد الفرج.
For example, a person closing the gap.
الحركة الواجبة هي الحركة التي إن لم يتحرك بها كانت الصلاة باطلة.
And then those movements in the prayer which are an obligation. Or those movements, if a person doesn't do them, then his prayer isn't accepted.
الآن هو يصلي مثلاً وجد على غترته نجاسة مثلاً وجد نجاسة على غترته أو على الجاكيت مثلاً.
As an example, a person is praying and in the middle of the prayer he finds on his scarf or on his jacket some form of impurity.
فماذا يصنع؟
So therefore, what does this person do?
لابد أن يخلع هذا الجاكيت أو يخلع هذا. فهذا هنا يجب عليه أن يتحرك هذه الحركة. نعم.
That this person has to now take off his jacket and remove his jacket because of the impurity on it.
نعم. مبطلة الصلاة.
And then therefore this is an obligatory form of movement in the prayer.
الكلام.
So now we come to those actions which invalidate the prayer, that break the person's prayer.
الكلام العمد مع العلم والذكر. يتكلم متعمدا عالما تحرم الكلام في الصلاة ذاكرا لا ناسيا. نعم.
Is a person who speaks intentionally and he knows that speaking the prayer breaks his prayer and he does so intentionally, i.e. not out of forgetfulness.
فلو تكلم ناسيا.
So if a person speaks in the prayer out of forgetfulness
أو جاهل تحريم الكلام في الصلاة
or a person speaks in the prayer but he doesn't know the ruling of speaking in the prayer
أو تكلم لمصلحة الصلاة أخطأ الإمام ففتح عليه وأخذ ينبه الإمام.
Or a person speaks in the prayer but only to correct the Imam. He realizes that Imam has made a mistake in his recitation, so he corrects him in the recitation.
فالصلاة صحيحة وإلا فهي باطلة.
The prayer is correct and anything else in the prayer becomes invalid.
الكلام العمد متعمد.
We said a person who speaks on purpose
عالم تحريم الكلام في الصلاة
and he knows the ruling of speaking the prayer that it isn't permissible
ذاكرا لا ناسيا
and he knows and he intends it and he isn't it isn't out of forgetfulness
فالصلاة باطلة.
So then if he does this then his prayer is invalid.
الأكل
eating
الشرب
drinking
الضحك
laughing
الالتفات الكثير عن القبلة
moving or diverting away from the Qibla a lot.
الحركة الكثيرة المتوالية عرفا لغير حاجة.
And we said also a person moving a lot consistently so that the people around him, they know, they think that he's not in the prayer.
انكشاف العورة.
And also from those matters which invalidate a person's prayer is the awrah, the private parts to become uncovered.
وهذا يحصل في من يصلي في المنطار.
And this often happens with those people who pray in trousers.
تكون صلاته باطلة عند الركوع عند السجود.
That often the case is that when he makes sujood, when he prostrates, when he bows, then his prayer becomes invalid.
يعني إن انكشفت العورة. ويحتاط قبل الدخول في الصلاة أنه لا تنكشف العورة عند الركوع عند السجود. نعم.
So his prayer becomes invalid if his awrah becomes uncovered. And therefore a person should be careful before he enters into the prayer to make sure that his awrah will remain covered in the prayer.
وانتقال الطهارة.
And also
من مبطلات الصلاة. يعني مثلا خرج منه ريح وهو يصلي. فماذا يصنع؟ يتم الصلاة؟ الصلاة الآن باطل. لابد أن يخرج. يقدم الخوف من الله سبحانه وتعالى يخرج يتوضا ويرجع. نعم.
And also when a person's wudu breaks. If a person's wudu breaks, if a person passes wind whilst he's in the prayer, then his prayer is invalid. And therefore he should fear Allah, go out and make his wudu and come back for the prayer.
نأخذ تقريبا 10 دقائق إلى الساعة السابعة إن شاء الله تعالى نرتاح فيها ونراجع ثم بعد هذا نواصل ما بدأنا فيه والله أعلم صلى الله على نبينا محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم.